In this video, I am going to explain basic anatomy of quadratus lumborum. Quadratus lumborum is deep core muscles, which on the kind of back of the belly. Okay, I am going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and important anatomical relationship with other muscle. Okay, so origin of quadratus lumborum is this part, the lower part. This part is iliac crest. Iliac crest, right? Iliac crest. And some information says quadratus lumborum also attaches on here. This structure, what is it? This is iliolumbar ligament. Iliolumbar ligament. Some anatomy books don't say it attaches on this ligament, but other info says it attaches on iliolumbar ligament. But if, let's say, if this muscle attaches on iliolumbar ligament, that can be very important factor for low back pain. In fact, the tight quadratus lumborum can induce low back pain. So I think there is connection between this muscle and ligament. Okay? Anyway, its origin is iliac crest and iliolumbar ligament. Okay, let's talk about its insertion. Insertion is this part and this part. This bony prominent is transverse process. Transverse process of lumbar spine. So it attaches on lumbar. That's why it is so connected for low back pain. Plus, its insertion is also here. This is 12th rib. Basically, it's on the core bones, on the ribs, on the lumbar spines. And origin is iliac crest and iliolumbar ligament. Just looking origin and insertion, it looks very important for core movement, core stability, and low back pain, right? Now I will talk about its function. So function of quadratus lumborum is side bend of trunk. Side bend. You bend trunk towards this way. Okay, but this is only when one side of the muscle contracts. I'm only showing you the right side of quadratus lumborum. But what if, imagine there is the left side here. Imagine what happens when both sides contract. Okay, what's gonna happen? It brings lumbar extension. Lumbar extension, okay. And plus, it can move pelvis. You know, this is when this movement happens, side bend. But if side bend happens, that can bring pelvis this way, okay? It can bring trunk this way. That means, in other words, it can bring pelvis this way, right? It's like a yin-yang relationship. This pelvic movement is also important. I will talk about it later. The basic movement is side bend and extension. Okay, now I will talk about the relationship with psoas muscle. Now I am looking the core from front view. This is quadratus lumborum, right side quadratus lumborum. And this is psoas. These two are very, very close each other. It's like almost facing each other. Quadratus lumborum, psoas. As I said, quadratus lumborum is very important for low back pain. Plus, psoas is very close to quadratus lumborum. So when, if quadratus lumborum gets tight, that can affect psoas, right? Vice versa, if psoas gets tight, that can affect quadratus lumborum as well. That's why these two muscles are kind of interrelated each other. This is very, very important. Why? Because psoas is also important for lumbar movement, lumbar stability, core movement. Very important muscle. The such important muscle faces to quadratus lumborum. That's very, very important. So this is the relationship with psoas. Now I'd like to talk about relationship with hip joint movement and pelvic movement regarding to quadratus lumborum. Now I'm looking at core from backside. This is quadratus lumborum. Its function, one of its functions is bring up pelvis this way, right? This kind of a pelvic movement happens when hip joint does abduction. Abduction is opening up leg sideways. Okay, it's like a ballet movement or open up leg stretch movement, right? So this is abduction. This pelvic movement happens with hip abduction, right? What is main hip abductor? Main hip abductor is gluteus medius plus gluteus minimus deep to gluteus medius. But what happens when these glutes muscle cannot function, or if they are too tight, they can't perform hip abduction very well? However, somebody has to compensate this inhibited hip abduction. Who has to do it? This guy has to do it. So quadratus lumborum has to work a lot if this muscle's movement is inhibited. What happens? Then this muscle needs to work too much. And quadratus lumborum is very important for tight low back and low back pain. That can induce low back pain. This hip joint muscle and quadratus lumborum relationship is very, very important. In fact, when I treat quadratus lumborum and gluteus medius, that can relieve tight hip joint and tight lumbar spines. I think that is from this relationship and this biomechanics. I will say that again. Main hip abductors are gluteus medius and gluteus minimus. If gluteus medius and minimus cannot function well, hip joint cannot abduct very well. However, body needs to move. Somebody has to compensate the movement. Who does it? Quadratus lumborum has to do it. This muscle is so connected for low back pain. Continuous use of quadratus lumborum can induce low back pain. This is very, very important. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of quadratus lumborum. I explained its origin, insertion, function, and relationship with other muscle, then biomechanical relationship. So if you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.